Hello, my friends, and welcome to The Chew. I'm Robert Wallace, and this is the place where we ask, are we choosing to follow the way of Jesus, or are we choosing our own way? Well, today we're looking at the way of Jesus is to enhance. The fact is, salt is both a preservative and an enhancer. How many times have you been walking around the neighborhood, or you get out of your car, and the aroma of well-seasoned food just hits you in the face, and all of a sudden you're drawn to it and your stomach starts to grumble like you're hungry? And before you got out of the car, before you turned the corner, you weren't even thinking about food. This is the property of salt. It enhances and it draws out flavor and it draws out those smells that we're drawn to. The way of Jesus enhanced life for everyone around him. He was never boring, and he enhanced both God and God's word. And Jesus reveals to us how we are to rightly apply God's righteousness to our lives now, today. Both the miracles that Jesus performed, turning water into wine, healing people, casting out demons, etc. All of these tell us how to live. Now, you might be wondering how. Well, it's real simple. Let's go back to Matthew chapter 5, verses 2 through 12, the Beatitudes. The truth is that Jesus cared for everyone around him. He expects us to do the same. We know that we're to love God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength, and our neighbor as ourselves. That's in Mark chapter 12, verses 30 and 31. So when we step back and we look at the way Jesus lived his life and the examples that he gave us for how to care for one another and to care for those, even our own enemies, invite you to go back and read the Last Supper. And Jesus said that the one who would betray him was in the room. Jesus even loved him, though he knew he was about to be betrayed. These are great truths, and they show the expanse of God's love. John tells us in 1 John chapter 3, verses 16 through 24, how we are to apply God's love. Now in verse 17, he says that if we have the means to help our brother and sister and we don't, then the love of God is not in us. When we are able to help someone in need, the expectation of God and Jesus is that we will take action. This is the very definition of enhancing someone's life. We easily identify with material needs in ourselves and in others. Well, what about taking the time to really hear what someone is telling us? Someone who is in need of a listening ear. What about the person who needs a ride to the doctor or the store? What about the person who needs an extra pair of hands to help around their place? What about the person who needs help? You fill in the blank. What about the person who needs to know Jesus? In verse 24 of 1 John chapter 3, John writes this: the one who keeps God's commands lives in him, and he, God, in them. And this is how we know that he lives in us. We know it by the Spirit he gave us. Are we enhancing the lives of those that live around us today? Are we preserving the righteousness of Jesus Christ by the way we live? Which way are we choosing? Are we choosing the way of Jesus, or are we choosing our own way? I pray that as you carefully consider the passages that I've shared with you here today, and as you consider what I've shared with you from my own thoughts. That you'll go dig into these passages and you'll invite the Holy Spirit to give you eyes to see and ears to hear God's truth from His Word. That you'll have a receptive heart and mind to receive these truths, and then that you're going to take a step of faith today with the same boldness, commitment, and courage of Jesus to act on what the Holy Spirit guides you to today. I pray you'll have a wonderful day, my friends. Go in the peace of God. Blessings to you. Bye for now.